Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to be talking about how to choose a business name for your business. So after my last video, a couple of people said they were still unsure about what exactly they need to do while they pick their business names, and I had a couple of people in my coaching program ask me questions over and over again, and I thought the best thing to do would be to make an in-depth video explaining every single thing that you need to know and giving you steps, tips and tricks to help you pick your business name easily. I understand that the first time you're picking your business name, it might be difficult. For someone like me, it takes me a few hours to come up with a new business name each time, and I'm sure you'll come to that point. But for now, let's get on with the video. So the first thing that I want you to consider while you're choosing your business name is to make sure that your business name is easy to spell. So you want a business name that is really easy to spell. You don't want something that people will start wondering, what exactly is the spelling? Is there an extra vowel? Are there extra consonants? Make it really simple, straightforward, and in such a way that once you say the name, people immediately know how to spell it. You don't want a case where people keep making mistakes spelling your name and then ending up in your competitor's website, or maybe not your competitor, but just somebody with a different business name, and automatically you have lost that customer because now they can't find you. So keep that in mind. You want a name that is really easy to spell. The second thing that you really need to consider is to choose a name that will not be limiting. I understand the excitement of starting a new business and then you're like, okay, I just want to pick this name, and you end up choosing a name that is so limiting that once you have a change of heart or you want to add new services, it becomes really difficult. So if you have a business name that says copywriting articles for $5.com, that's really difficult because you only write articles and you only do it for $5. So that raises a problem because now you cannot change your services to include any other thing. So let's say besides copywriting, you want to start offering strategy as well. It will be really confusing if people come to your site or hear your business name to figure out exactly what you offer, or even realize that you offer other services besides copywriting for articles. So you should definitely make sure that your name is not limiting. Make it something that if you do decide to change your business model, your services or whatever, you can still use that business name. Because if you use a particular business name for quite a while, people tend to associate you with that brand, and it will just be much easier to rebrand your services rather than to entirely rebrand yourself. So you have to keep that in mind. The third thing I want you to consider is to do a thorough research before you choose your business name. When you have gotten one that you actually like, before you finalize on it, you have to do research and make sure that the name does not mean something weird in another language, or it's not something sacred where you start having conflicts with people. Make sure that it is not copyright protected. Someone else does not already own a trademark for that particular name. Do your research to make sure that the name that you're choosing, you can absolutely make use of it, right? So it has to be something that you can use and not something that you run into issues. A good example would be when ConvertKit changed their name to Sever. There was this transitionary period, and for a big company like that, which is an email marketing platform, they had to do a lot of stuff. They had to create new domains, do all the Sever switches, and just after switching, they discovered that the word Sever and the symbol they were using was actually something sacred to a group of people, I can't remember from where, and then they had to switch their name back to ConvertKit. That's a lot of cost. Now, I know it may not be a cost on that level for you as a small business owner, but at the same time, you want to save yourself the manpower and just the mental energy of switching your brand after finding out that you can't use that name. So after you have done these three steps, the next thing that you have to do is actually check if the name is available, right? You have to go to NameChecker and see. I like to use namechecker.com. You can use it to check the availability across social media networks. So you want to make sure that it's available on Facebook, it's available on Instagram. You can open a Twitter account, a Pinterest account, and if, for example, somebody has the name in one of the social media accounts, is it something that you can modify? Maybe you can just add an extra word to your name and create a brand that you actually like. Make sure it's available. Don't get excited over a name and then you discover that they have purchased the .com, the .net, the .org, and the .co, so you can't even own that particular brand name. Make sure to do your research before you finalize on it. Number five, before you decide on a name, I strongly advise that you should make sure that the name means something to you. I understand that when you're trying to pick a business name, it might become really difficult because a lot of names are already taken. It seems like all the domains are already owned by somebody else, or maybe even the domain you like, they're asking you to pay $2,500 for it because it's a premium domain. I understand how that might feel, but you still want to choose a business name that means something to you. That should not push you into choosing a business name that just doesn't, you don't care about it. It's just, oh, this was what was available, so that's what I'm going to go with. So you want to choose a business name that means something to you and is still available, so that when people ask you what your business name is, you will be proud enough to say it and to explain exactly what you do. Number six thing that you have to ensure is that the name is not trademarked or copyrighted. You can do a quick search in the databases. You can do a database search in the US, UK, and Canada, as these are most of the major players in when it comes to online business. And you make sure that the name that you're going with, someone else has not already trademarked the name. It is not enough to check if the domain is already owned by somebody else or if there's a social media platform that has a username, because there are times when people actually purchase names as trademarks and they don't use it. They just keep it in case they come up with an idea or maybe for a project that they're still trying to get funding for. So you don't want to get into issues where you go on and open up all the social media accounts and buy the domain and everything else, and then you discover that it's trademark, because legally you are going to have to back off. So you want to make sure that the name that you actually choose is free of trademarks and copyright. Now, this is a fun fact, and this is something you should definitely consider. Find a name that is catchy, because catchy names catch on. You want your customers to be able to remember your name whenever they want to recommend you to someone else. You want people to remember your name whenever they want to find you online or find your services or send it to someone or share it with someone else. So if your name is not catchy, people will tend to forget. So they will not have to actually go through their emails or find that one conversation both of you had to find out what your business name is in order for them to get back to you or recommend you to someone else. So the catchier the name, the better. And as much as you try to look for a catchy name, don't try to make it so catchy that you lose integrity as a business. You still want your name to be professional. So keep that in mind. Now, when you have done all of these steps from number one to seven, number eight thing I want you to do is actually ask for feedback. I know you must have been in your bubble, coming up with all the creative names that you can think of. And then once you have decided on something, it's available, there is no trademark or copyright, I actually advise that you don't come up with just one. Maybe you come up with about 3 to 5 that you like, and you could actually go with any of them. Obviously, you might still have your preference, but that's fine. And then what you do is you ask for feedback from your friends, your family, or if you're too shy to talk to your friends and family, you can go on a Facebook group that you're a part of and ask them what they think of the name. A word of caution though, if your name is too good, if the name you came up with is so good, somebody else might just go and steal it. You know that not everybody in the world is good and has integrity. So be careful of where you ask, so that you make sure that somebody does not take a name that you not actually like. So ask for feedback, see how other people like the name. How people like it, is it something that they actually think, oh, this is nice, I like this? Or when you tell them what your business name is, can they figure out at least one of the things that you do or what field that you currently exist in? So that's really important, that you get feedback from people as to how easy it is to remember, how easy it is to spell, and how catchy it is. And if people are able to associate your brand name with what you actually do. For example, if you have a business that does design, and when you tell people your business name, it sounds like you're a construction company or an architectural company, that's a problem. So you want to make sure that your services or whatever you're selling actually aligns with the name that you choose. The next thing I want you to do is actually say your name out loud. So maybe people will have mixed reactions, some people might like a few of them, and it will finally be up to you to choose exactly what you would finally go with. So in that case, I want you to say your name out loud multiple times to make sure that you like how the name rolls off your tongue and you're actually very comfortable with the name as a person. Number 10 thing is to make sure that the name is visually appealing. You don't want a name, for example, that it's a compound word, and what happens is that whenever you write it out, it looks like there are certain words that you can see. For instance, if you start to see ass in the middle of your business name, that's not a good thing. If you start seeing swear words in the middle of your business name when you write it out, that's not also a good thing. So make sure that when you write it out or type it out, it actually looks good and it's not too long. This is really important because if it's too long, nobody will want to type it out. So make sure that I recommend that your character should be around 15 characters, thereabout. That's a good place to be. So these 10 things will help you to choose your business name. But if you're still feeling stuck, I have a few tips for you that will help you get out of that zone of being stuck. So number one thing is you're going to take a piece of paper and you're going to take a pen, and I want you to write down words that come to mind, words that you like. What do you think should be associated with your brand? How do you want your client to feel when they work with you? What kind of person are you? What are your core values? What are the things you like that can still be associated with your brand? Because at the end of the day, it is your business and it's going to be something that you live with. Now, something I also like to add is that you don't need to choose a name that you will die with. Like, it doesn't have to be a name that you will go to the grave with. It's just, you just need to pick a name that will be good for the shorter long term, if that's the thing. So think about, can I go by this business name for the next 6 to 8 months, 1 year? And if along the line you change your services, maybe you have a new line of thought or business or whatever, you can still change your name along the line. That's completely fine. To give you an example, when I started, I used a pseudonym as my business name. It was Christabel Dubois. You can still search for it and see some of my old stuff. And then I was doing that because I didn't want anybody to know exactly what I did or that it was associated back to me as a person. But eventually I rebranded everything to her online brand, and that's the name I'm going with. Now, this is a brand that I started out as a freelancer. I was offering services. My services changed from administrative to graphic design, web design, and eventually I ended up doing tech and sales funnels, digital marketing. But because of the way my name was, I was able to easily switch without confusing people. In fact, my present clients never knew that I actually did design back in the day. Now this particular business has been rebranded again to teach you how to start your own profitable business online. And I have moved my services to a different website and a different brand name as Funnel Tech Geniuses, which is an agency I'm currently running. So that's how versatile your business name should be, in such a way that you'll be able to switch from one thing to the other without dying or being stuck into a box. So that's it for today. I'm glad you watched this video, and I hope the tips are really helpful. So if you're still running into any issues, you can leave your questions down in the comment section and I'll be sure to reply. I would love to know what final business names you chose and what exactly you do. So what I would like you to do is to tell me what business name you went with in the comment section, and then I'll try to guess exactly what you do, and then after that, you can tell me exactly what you do. And it's also a good opportunity to meet other entrepreneurs just like you. So thank you for watching the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.